Good evening, good afternoon. This is Kerry Schumann from Chelsea Community Cable Television. We've been sent here by Robert Duke Bradley, Executive Director of the TV station in Chelsea, to cover the Chelsea High School Class of 1959 59th Reunion. And we have the dignitaries here that have led the way, including Class President Robert Bobby Tiro, committee member Butchie Bradley. Butch Bradley is related to Duke Bradley, and the fabulous, the personable Minna Caris Marino. She is heavily involved in this great event. Mr. President, it's great to see you. First of all, the Tiro family, you know, the legendary Chubby Tiro, one of the greatest athletes in our school's history. What do you want to say about today and being here for the 59th reunion?
It's fantastic to see all of these people come back. One of the great things about our class is the camaraderie that we all seem to have. As they walked in the door, it was like 59 all over again. Huh, Butchie? We really like this. We like each other, and it shows as the night will go on, you'll see, as you move from table to table. And Minner is the one who, you know, got the idea about all of this, the 59 is 60.
What happened was, Frank Kowalski and myself were attending a funeral. It was your mother's. And Frank said, why do we have to wait? And it hit me in the head. We don't have to wait. I threw it out to some of the committee members, and that's why we're here tonight.
And Howie Darish was very influential in getting things moving.
Yeah.
He just takes care of everything from Florida. He touches us like he's next door, gets things in motion, collaborates with Bobby, with Minna, and he does wonderful. And we're wishing him well. He's in a little bit of a problem right now health-wise, and we're wishing him the best of everything. He's a great kid.
Okay, well, we're standing in the brand-new Homewood Suites Hotel. This obviously wasn't here in 1959.
No, it wasn't.
What do you think of the new Chelsea compared to the Chelsea of the late 50s?
I'm telling you, it was a thing that should have happened, truthfully, a long time ago. This land was here, and somebody finally saw the investment of what it could mean, not only for the hotel management, but for the city of Chelsea. I'm just happy for the city of Chelsea.
This room is named after Jay Ash, who was instrumental in the revitalization of Chelsea. We're actually in the Jay Ash function room. Mr. Bradley, it's great to see you. What do you want to say about being here and the Chelsea of the 1950s?
Well, just that I'm glad to be here with all my my dear friends. The friends you grow up with, there's no fooling anybody here. We grew up together, side by side. We know who we are. We love who we are. And it's always an absolute joy to be together with everybody. It's something that those who don't attend, I feel a little sorry for, to be honest with you. There's so many more who would love to see here. And the years go by, they click away, and you don't get many second chances. So I just wish that more would have come.
Okay, let's move over, Minna. The unsung hero of this committee, it looks like. Minna, it's great to see you. What do you want to say about this great event?
I'm hungry.
Okay. All right. Well, right now it's the social hour, right?
Yes,
okay.
Yes.
We're in the midst of the social hour.
Standing over there.
A special guest has arrived. Minna, tell us about the committee, how long it took to find everyone and get everyone here.
It took quite a while. This was
Okay.
Stop.
Minna, we're on television.
I can't help it.
All right. This happens. This is happening as it happens. There's no script here.
Oh.
And this gentleman's walking in the middle of the camera. It happens. Who's this?
Robert Leonard.
Hi, Mr. Oh.
Hi.
Oh, we know the Leonard family. Turn around. Turn around. We're on television, Mr. Leonard. Look. That way.
How
okay,
are you?
We were talking to the committee, but as long as you're here, how's it feel to be here?
It feels good. I'm not from this class. My wife is.
Oh, you're not even a classmate.
Beverly.
Oh, Beverly, come on in. Okay. Wait, we're moving on here.
Okay.
Well, this hasn't been so organized, but that's the fun of it, I guess. How are you, Beverly? What's it like to be back here 59 years later?
Really unbelievable. Everybody looks great. Yeah. I mean, I can't believe how good people look. Yeah. Now, we're old. 76. That's tough, you know? There's aches and pains. But other than that, everybody that I see so far looks great.
So what street did you grow up on in Chelsea? Poplar.
Yeah,
very nice.
Right, Poplar Street.
Wow.
Down, you know, right off of, you know, where all the bar rooms were. Do you remember? I used to walk by that.
Wow.
What was that? What street was that?
Fifth Street.
Right down from Fifth Street.
Okay.
And, I'm happy to be alive. What can I tell you? Long as we're breathing.
So which of the junior highs did you attend?
Williams.
You went to Williams, of
course.
Yeah,
went to Williams.
Yeah. So what do you remember about Chelsea in the 1950s, growing up in the 50s?
We were a great city. I lived there till I moved to Peabody.
Yeah.
I brought up two kids till, third and fourth grade.
Yeah.
And then I moved, and the best time of my life was Chelsea, I got to tell you.
And you're part of the famous Leonard family now.
I'm part of the Leonard family, yep.
Yes.
And now, you know, I mean, I remember Shapiro's and Foxy's.
Oh, sure.
All the delis.
Broadway, yep.
We used to hang around Shapiro's.
How about Marionetti's?
Marionetti's, Sam's.
Yeah, Pressman's, yes.
Yeah, come on.
Yep.
I mean, I grew up there.
Wow.
I was a little kid. I grew up in Chelsea. I was born in Chelsea, the Chelsea Hospital.
Oh, Chelsea Memorial Hospital on Bellingham Street,
Yep.
Wow.
Yep.
Very nice.
It was great, I can only tell you.
Well, it's great to see you. Have a nice time today.
I'm going
to
try my best, honey.
Okay.
And you have a good time, too.
Yo, it's been fun so far.
Okay, love you.
Thank you. We have three dynamic guests here from the class of 1959. Classmates, they're here again today. At the Homewood Suites Hotel, we have Richard Pizzuto, Arthur Selby, and Frank Kowalski, who needs no introduction to the city of Chelsea, the great Kowalski family. How you doing, Rich? It's great to see everyone.
Thank you. Nice seeing you, Gary. Nice being here with the whole group of people. It's nice that they all turned up. And I can't believe how the transition to Chelsea is fantastic. Five hotels, growing like crazy. I couldn't afford to live here anymore. Fabulous.
What sport did you play in high school?
I was the worst basketball player. I was the worst center in base and football.
Yeah.
I played baseball, but I could only sit on the bench. That was my three great sports.
And the guy next year was a great basketball player, wasn't he?
The best there ever was. Well, we didn't win very many games, but we had a good time.
But he never passed the ball.
Well, I found out later that I was blind in one eye, so that's why I didn't see the other players.
Who was the coach, Arthur?
Saul Nechtum.
Oh, Saul Nechtum became the athletic director, too.
Yes. And what Saul taught me was if you don't shoot, you can't score.
Yep.
So I started shooting and never stopped.
Yep.
And where he lives now at near Dartmouth College, the coaches are there that don't want him to kill the poor kids trying coming off the basketball up there.
Oh, you're up in Hanover, New Hampshire?
No, I live in White River Junction, 5.5 miles from the campus. And I used to play basketball until I was 57 every day for 2 hours. And then everything went wrong. A new hip, a new shoulder, and that's the end of that.
All right, we're going to move on to Frank Kowalski. Mr. Kowalski, I saw your wife here. She looks marvelous.
Thank you, guys.
The great Pat Kowalski. Yeah. How's it feel to be here with all your classmates?
Oh, it's just unbelievable to see all my old friends. There's so many of them that came in to be with us this afternoon, and again, it's just wonderful. Going to be celebrating 60 years of graduating fabulous Chelsea High School, and again, the city of Chelsea has been just so good, and it's come back so far, and we just have so many wonderful things happening here, and again, it all starts with the people that are here in the city, and the people that are here today that we're Chelsea and still are Chelsea.
What do you remember about the old Chelsea in the 50s?
Oh, there's just so many things. Chelsea, back in the day with Bellingham Square and Tony Spire and all the places that we hung out, was just a wonderful, wonderful city to grow up in.
Okay. And you brought your lovely wife here today and the children and grandchildren.
Yeah, we have a... Fantastic family, yes. Four kids and 11 grandkids, and it's just, again, life has really been very, very good to me, and I hope I can continue it on.
You're a great man. It's so great to see you.
Thank you, Kerry. Very good.
We're with James Cialone from the class of 59. What's it like being here today with your classmates?
Well, it's always pleasant to see you. You know, the time goes by fast, and you don't know how long we're going to be around, so we're just trying to get together and enjoy everybody, and it's always good. I wish I could see some of the people that I haven't seen since high school, but some of the people just don't show up. But they're really missing something, I think, anyway.
What part of Chelsea did you grow up in?
Well, we actually started out at Vale Street because I was born on Vale Street. But the bridge moved us out. I ended up down Gilooly Road. And, you know, I was thinking, I said, we're still around, and that bridge looks like it's falling apart, but we're still around here. So
I don't know. Play at Gilooly Park?
Yes, I did. Yeah, they still have the playground there. And
where are you living now?
I still live on Bloomingdale Street. Been there since 55.
Oh, very nice.
Yeah, neighborhood's changed a little bit, but it's still good. You know.
Okay. Great to see you.
Nice to see you too.
Go ahead. Who do we have behind us?
Oh, we have two big committee members, important: Helen McGinnis Holland and Loretta Taylor Gordon. These two guys are instrumental throughout the time. They work hard. Loretta has a backlog of all of us, names and addresses, and consistently keeps me updated with all the information, you know, what might be done. And we do this the whole time before the reunion, how many are coming, how many are not. But she's been excellent. And these were the gift, the so-called container from her sister, or her daughter.
Oh, wait, hold on. Oh, what's her name?
Trisha Holland.
Oh, we know Trisha. That's your daughter. So she donated these?
Yeah, she donated them.
What are they? Let's give us some. Oh, very nice.
A little gift, yeah.
19th. Oh, the famous Holland family. We know the Hollands.
Trisha, Raymond, and Donald. Yeah.
What's it like to be back with your classmates here today?
Oh, good. I still live in Chelsea on Tudor Street. Across from the temple.
Do you watch Chelsea Community Cable Television, I hope?
Oh, yeah. I've known Jamie for a long time.
Okay. Jamie's the photographer, and you obviously read the Chelsea Record every week.
Yeah, I have it delivered.
Oh,
yeah.
Wonderful. Yeah. How are you, Loretta?
I'm doing fine.
Are you happy to see everybody?
I really am. I love being a part of Class of 59. We have the best class. We have people here who have been lifelong friends since we were grade school.
I like the idea. We didn't wait for the 60th. We said we're going to do it for 59.
We ran the 59.
Wait, we had one of our dear classmates die last week, Fred Nowicki.
Oh, what a wonderful man, Mr. Nowicki. I know his children very well.
I used to hang around with him when I was 16, too.
Yeah. His son, Paul, one of the greatest athletes in our history.
Yeah. Everything was good. We're going to have a blast.
Okay, let's have a happy occasion and... we'll pay tribute to Mr. Nowicki, I guess, later. Yes. Wonderful man. Nice seeing you, ladies. Okay. Jamie, let's move on. How are you? Okay. Hi.
How are you?
Good to see you. Say hello to the people of Chelsea.
Oh, hi, Chelsea.
Introduce yourself.
My name is Sal Shortino. I'm here with my wife. It's her reunion.
Oh, so where's your wife?
Right over there. Oh.
Well, do you mind if we get her on?
Absolutely.
Okay. This is the classmate. Hi. You're the classmate. Your husband was trying to steal the thunder. What's your name?
Antonia.
And your last name?
My marriage name is Shortino.
And how about your maiden name?
Maglione.
Oh, there you go. And where did you grow up?
Chelsea.
What street?
Let's see. Went from Shirtliff Street, Parkway, that area.
So did you start out at the Shirtliff School?
Did I what?
Did you go to Shirtliff School to start?
No. I came from East Boston originally,
so
I came to Chelsea.
All right. So what's it like to be here today?
I don't know. I'm going to see. I don't remember any looking around. I don't recognize anybody so far.
Okay.
So.
Any memories of Chelsea you'd like to share?
No, they were the best years I had. Great. Chelsea High School was the best years I had.
Okay. Thank you.
You're welcome.
All right. Hi, guys.
No, we're not.
Where'd you go?
Medford High.
We don't want Mustangs, no.
Chelsea.
We want the Red Devils, I'm sorry.
He's a Red Devil.
What brings you here today?
My wife is a graduate of 57.
Where is she?
Audrey Layton Schiff. She's wearing a red, she's talking to a gentleman right here.
Oh, okay. Yeah. All right. Hi. Here you are.
Yes.
Okay, Elaine Silverman
Reiser.
Okay. Father was the great Sam Silverman.
That's right.
The boxing pro, legendary boxing pro. Okay, all right. So what's it like to be back with your classmates?
Fabulous. It was the best years of my life. I took a tour of Chelsea yesterday, saw the homestead, saw all the places I hung out at. Chelsea looks good, I have
what
to say.
What places did you hang out at?
Cary Square, Anastas, Temple Emmanuel. That whole area was my territory. And up on the hill, past where the Carter School was, 5 Parker Street.
Yes.
Yes.
You attended the Carter School.
Yes.
Through grade 9.
Yes.
And then you went on to Chelsea High for 3
right.
years.
Yes. And then I went on to Fisher College.
Okay.
And now I live in Sharon.
Oh. And you're the daughter of a legendary boxing promoter, Sam Silverman. He was great, wasn't he?
Yes, he was. My claim to fame, that I'm his daughter.
Yeah, did you get to meet Muhammad Ali?
Yes.
Oh, what was he like? The greatest.
Yes, and he knew he was the greatest. He let everybody know he was the greatest.
Well, like a butterfly, sting like a bee.
And
you can't hit what you can't see.
Right, my dad gave Rocky Marciano a start, Marvin Hagler a start.
Yes.
And I remember fighters carrying me on their shoulders. It was a great childhood.
What was Rocky like? Undefeated as a heavyweight champion, Rocky Marciano.
Well, I can tell you a story if you got time.
Yes.
One morning at 8 in the morning on a Sunday, my father would never let any friends of mine come to the house that early. He always slept late. The doorbell rings. I get out of bed, and who's standing there? Rocky. Rocky says to me, "Wake your father up. I got Jackie Gleason in the car. He wants to. He has to lose 10 pounds. Within a week. I want you to take him to one of the training camps so he can lose the weight." So my father got dressed. We went into the limousine. It was the longest limousine. I swear to God, it took up half of Parker Street. And we went out to Acton to drop Kip Murphy's training camp.
Wow.
And that was my story about Rocky Marciano.
Tell us about Jackie Gleason. What was he like?
Very quiet.
Yeah.
Very quiet.
Yeah.
I think he was embarrassed.
Did you tell him you liked the Honeymooners?
Wow.
You've met some famous people.
Yes, I did. Oh. Sugar Ray Robinson carried me up a flight of stairs.
Oh, my word. Wow. You should do a whole show on this. We'll have to talk to Mr. Bradley, Robert Bradley, and get you on TV.
I'd love to do it anytime.
Great to see you.
Same
have
here.
A great time today.
Thank you.
Okay. All right. Let's move over here. Mrs. Schiff. Is this Mrs. Schiff? Excuse me.
Yes.
Well, I talked to your husband, but he's not the classmate. You're a classmate. This is Paula Siegel. You are a classmate. Audrey Schiff, what's it like to be here today?
It's wonderful. I love it. I love it. It's great. I've been looking forward to it, and I'm just happy to be here, really.
What are your memories of Chelsea back in the 50s?
Fabulous. We had a wonderful, wonderful time growing up in Chelsea.
Paula, your memories?
Great. Best time ever in my life. Nothing negative was great.
What street did you grow up on?
I grew up on Highland and Chester.
Okay, so you were a shirtlift girl?
I was a shirtlift girl,
and
yes.
And on to Chelsea High. How about you, Audrey?
No, I went. I grew up in Prattville, so I went to Prattville, and then I went to
Carter School, yes.
In between, and then high school. So I didn't really meet her until high school.
At the YMHA.
Oh, you hung out at the YMHA.
We had a great group there. Yeah. We had a lot of fun. And all these people.
Yeah.
Very good. Yes.
A lot of us stay close all these years. Yeah.
It was a close class.
Very close class. Don't you think
great.
So? Yeah,
really nice.
I do.
It's great to see you here today.
Well, thank you. It's good to be here, too.
Okay.
Very nice of you.
Okay. Here's Mrs. Kowalski. Just say hello.
Hello, how are you?
Okay, she's... You're so beautiful, you have to say hello.
Hello. Hi, I'm glad to be here.
Okay. We talked to your husband. He's also happy to be here, and it's great to see him.
Absolutely.
Yes.
It was a great class. I wasn't in it, but it was a great class.
Okay. Nice to see you.
Nice seeing you, too.
Okay. All right. Hi, how are you?
Good.
This is Daniel Fronczak. Your lady, Andrew? Is Andrew?
Andrew and Michael. Oh. You remember those guys.
Of course. Are you kidding? They were both great athletes, great young men.
We had.
How are they doing?
Excellent. They're all out in the underworld, working away.
Yeah.
You miss Peter. Peter was the younger brother. He went on to great things, too.
We know them all.
That's it. So.
Wow.
Big time.
Yeah. What are you up to?
We're sitting here talking to you right now.
Okay, yeah. It's like they asked Yogi Berra, what time is it? Do you mean right now?
Well, yeah.
Okay. So what's it like to be back with your classmates?
Fun.
Yeah.
We haven't seen them in 9 years was our last reunion. So everybody came back. The faces are still the same, just a little more aging, you know?
Yeah.
But the personalities come out. Everything's there.
And what does your lovely wife want to say?
Hi.
Not much, because it's not my class.
Oh, you weren't in this class.
No, she was in 61.
Oh, okay.
So she came a couple of years later.
Yeah.
With some of the wives, too. Some of them were 61s or later. And that's what you kick into.
So you saw John F. Kennedy becoming president in 1960, won the election.
Yeah.
So do you remember him back then?
Oh, yeah. Met him on the streets, too, in Boston.
Oh, you did?
Yeah.
Oh, wow. What a memory that is, meeting President Kennedy.
There you go.
Yes.
Back when.
Yeah. Wow.
That's it.
Thank you.
Thank
Great
you.
To see you. Say hello to the boys.
I will.
Okay. All right, Jamie, let's move on. Oh, who's this gentleman?
Steve Lurie.
How are you, Mr. Lurie?
Very good.
How's it feel to be back here?
Feels great. I'm here with my twin brother. We never thought we'd make it.
Yep.
And we always have a good crowd. Always get a good crowd.
Yep.
And that's good.
Yeah, where you living now?
And we're not going to charge you for any of this because I'm up at 5 Admirals Way.
Oh, very nice. Right there, right? So you're right
this
in Chelsea.
My brother. Been in Chelsea 75 years.
Oh, wow.
So I missed 2 years.
Yeah. you know Chelsea well, that if you've been here 75 years.
Let me tell you something. When I moved from Framingham to here, people said, how could you?
Yeah.
I know one party that didn't become friends because we're still in Chelsea. That's okay.
Yeah.
Not a friend.
Okay.
Take care, buddy.
Good okay. Jamie, let's go in the hall.
I'm from Josh all the time.
Yeah. Okay, let's move in the hall. All right. Here's the DJ for today. George Athos, Chelsea Public Library. Jamie's the photographer.
Oh, hi, Jamie.
Say hello to Duke Bradley back at home.
Dukey. The Senior Center went excellent this week. For all you people there in TV land, you miss a great time at that Senior Center once a month, and I'm doing a great show. Check it out, either Channel 3 or 15, whatever. Duke, he owns more channels than Ted Turner ever owned. So check out the networks.
So what songs are we playing today? I hope we have Elvis in the mix.
Absolutely. We got a lot of doo-wop, the style of the 50s. I might even get out there and do a spin, you know, that 70, class of 76. Yeah. We rule, but this is a great crowd, and I'm looking forward to the party tonight. Absolutely.
Okay. Always a pleasure, George Athos.
I will see you at the party, my friend.
Yes.
Take care, Chelsea.
Okay. Hi. How are you, sir? Your name?
Nunzio.
Oh, wow. Oh, my word. You were my camp counselor.
I was what?
I'm Kerry Schumann. I went to Camp Roby. Nunzio Benevento. Oh, you knew my brother Eric, too.
Yes.
Oh, my word. How you doing?
Good, good. Long ride in, but it was good.
So this is your class?
My class, yeah.
Where are you living now?
Marshfield.
So what's it like to be back in Chelsea?
Well, I just got off the bridge, so I didn't see too much of it.
Oh, okay.
But I've been around. The old expression, you can take the kid out of Chelsea, but you can't take Chelsea out of the kid.
What are your memories of Chelsea in the 50s?
I don't know. 15 cent toll on the Tolbert Bridge.
Right.
All right.
Okay, great to see you, Nunzio. Right. My pleasure. Wow. Gee, Jamie, I went to camp. He was my counselor. There we are. Now, let's move over here. Can you say hello to the people, Chelsea? This is Carol.
Hello, Carol Fienda Kenny.
How are you?
I'm good, thank you.
What's it like to be here today, Carol?
It's awesome. Yeah? It is just awesome to see all these old faces. Some of us started in kindergarten together and graduated together. Yeah.
What are your memories of Chelsea back then?
I loved Chelsea.
What street did you grow up on?
I grew up on Marlborough Street.
Okay.
There was no other place in the world to grow up.
Yep.
It was the best place in the world. Yeah. No matter where you go.
Yes.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah. It's changed a lot, but it's still home.
Yeah, you were right near the library.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Definitely. Walked down the street. There was a little alley.
It's still there, and it's going well. We have a great library.
Yes, it's great.
Where are you living now?
I live in Plymouth, Mass., in Cape Coral, Florida.
Oh, very nice. Yes.
Here for my children, grandchildren. Yes.
Very nice. So you get to see the Plymouth Rock.
Oh, yeah. Abuijo.
Yeah.
That big.
Yeah,
right?
But it's still an important part of our history.
Right. Thank you very much.
Nice to see you.
Nice seeing you, too.
My pleasure. Okay. Who's this gentleman? How are you?
Good. How are you?
Okay. This is Joseph Sanderson.
That's right. How are you?
Good. Are you related to Sanderson's on Broadway, that store?
Smoke shop.
Yes.
Yeah.
How are you related to that store?
It was my uncle.
Oh, wow. What a great store that was. Near Tony's Spa, right?
Correct. Right next door.
And hardware, the hardware store. Chelsea Hardware.
Bellingham Hardware.
Bellingham Hardware, right.
Murray Youngman was the manager there.
Yeah. So what are your memories other than that of Chelsea?
Great memories. Chelsea was a great town. I still love it. Yeah. Best town in the world for me.
What street did you grow up on?
Bellingham Street.
Oh, okay. So you went to Sheriff School?
No, I went to Carter School.
Oh, you went to Carter?
Right.
Oh, okay.
Why, I don't know.
I know. I thought that was Sherlock territory. Yeah. That's okay.
But Sherlock didn't want me, so I went to Carter.
Did you have good years at Chelsea? I had 3 years there, right?
Yeah. Excellent. The best years of my life.
Any favorite teachers you remember? The principal?
No.
Okay.
They're all good.
They're all good.
I spent more time in the principal's office than he did. So,
But you turned out all right. You look great.
I feel good. Thank you.
Okay.
Thank you.
Nice to see you. Okay. All right. Hi. Sorry to interrupt, but we're on television. Let me get you on it. Stephen Voltero, class of 1959.
Correct.
What's it like to be here today, sir?
Beautiful, because everybody's still alive.
Yeah. Everybody looks great.
Well, I don't know about great, but they look alive. For this age, it's pretty fantastic.
And what are your memories of Chelsea back in 59, 58?
It was a lot smaller,
yeah.
A lot more intimate. Now we got all these buildings all around us, like the Great Wall of China.
Well, it looks good, Chelsea. We like Chelsea.
I love Chelsea.
Yeah. Yep.
I've always been proud that I come from Chelsea.
Very nice. It's nice to see you here today.
Excellent.
Thank you.
Nice to see anybody.
I'm going to talk to Jay Barry Dwyer. Wow. Okay, here's a Chelsea legend. Cross-country coach extraordinaire. It's Jamie, and say hello to Duke Bradley. He's listening.
Hi, Duke.
Back home.
Hey, I haven't seen you in a while, the Duke, and
okay.
I miss you.
Now, what sports did you do at Chelsea High?
Just track.
Okay.
That's the only thing I participated in.
Yep.
And, of course, the legendary Bernard Berenson.
Yes.
My dad was a careerman in the Army, so I didn't see him. There are other reasons, too. He was like a dad to me.
Yeah.
And I idolized him, and when that opportunity arose, he submitted his resignation one night, Carrie, at a school committee meeting when I was on the school committee, and Mr. Quigley says, well, we'll abolish cross country. I said, no, you can't do that. And the rest is history. I said, I'll do it. And I was on the school committee. I took the job without any salary. It didn't matter to me.
Yeah,
it
was some great years of cross country.
That was
Bobby Goss and the Richard Brothers.
Oh, yeah.
And
yeah.
The Rosati's. Amazing.
Carrie, I have to say this, I've said it time and time again, beside having children, those are my most gratifying years because those kids brought me so much happiness and how successful they were and how they turned out as people. And they were just great. I was looking at a plaque on my office the other day. Bobby Goss, all scholastic, 40 years ago this year, 1978.
Wow.
40 years ago, yeah.
Nice to see all your classmates here.
Great, we had a great class. I know a lot of people say that, but the class of 59 really is amazing. And I even have a stronger personal relationship with some kids like Bobby Tiro. I don't want to miss names.
The class president.
We went all the way through Shirtless School, so I've known them all those years.
Wow.
And a lot of them are here today. There's Bobby there. A lot of them are here tonight, and it's just so great.
The committee has done an exceptional job. The hall looks beautiful, yeah. Well, you deserve credit, too.
Well, deserves all the credit. Helen McGinnis, she has another name since we've been married. I'm good at maiden names.
Frank Kowalski, certainly Bobby Tarro, yeah. One of the Laurie twins. I can't tell them apart, you know. Yeah. One of them, Steven. Yeah.
So was Bobby Tarro a good class president?
He's an excellent class president. Yeah, yeah, but, and I was vice president in Shirtless School because he was class president there, too.
I think Chubby Tarro, his brother, was class president, too, wasn't he?
I couldn't even run against him, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, of course. I had to concede, yeah, Bobby, you got to be the president.
Yeah.
And he's a better president than most. He was a wonderful a great human being, too.
Okay. Nice to see you, Mr. Dwyer.
Thanks for asking me to say a word or two, Carrie.
Sure, my pleasure.
One of the greatest sports people, done more for Chelsea High Sports than anybody. Okay. And I've dealt with a few of them.
Well,
appreciate it.
Thank you so much. Thank you. Okay. How are you? Can you say a few words or are you busy eating? Stand up for a second. All right. This is John Clark. Okay, John Clark, what's it like to be here today, John?
Oh, it's great. I'm lucky to be here. I have melanoma cancer, but I'm surviving that pretty well, and hopefully many years to come. And and my wife just passed away. I'm living on my own now.
So it brings you a lot of happiness to see your classmates, I'm sure.
Oh, it does. Yes. Yeah. Yeah. Especially my old friend here.
What's his name?
Tony Rizzo.
Come on, stand up. He just called you a great friend. Come on up. Okay.
Yeah, he's my first friend.
This is it. Oh, Anthony Rizzo. We know Anthony Rizzo. The Rizzo family.
Yeah,
yes.
We were in the first grade.
At Sherliff?
No,
St. Rose.
Yeah.
And then you went on to Chelsea High, grade 10?
Well, I went to Sherliff School, beginning of the ninth grade. And then I went to the high school.
How many sports did you play?
Football, track.
How were you in football?
Pretty good. Made all scholastic.
You were an all scholastic? Jamie, all scholastic here. Hold on, John. You didn't tell me he was an all scholastic. What position?
I was a tackle.
Wow.
I went out to the university on a full scholarship. Football.
What school?
University of Minnesota.
Oh, a Gopher.
Yeah,
the Gophers. Division One.
Yep, that's right.
Wow, you were in the Big Ten.
Yeah, I just made the freshman team. There was 11 freshman teams, and I was running on the second team. Imagine 11 freshman teams. That's how big the football squad was.
Wow.
Those years, those 2 years that I was there, I didn't go to there. Or they went to the Rose Bowl.
Wow. Who was the head Chelsea High football coach in 58?
Coach McCarthy.
Henry McCarthy.
Yeah, he's been there for since I was a kid. I don't know what time he when he retired, but it must have been a long time.
He was a legend himself.
Yeah, so he was. Yep. He was like Mr. Henry at the Shirtless School.
Joseph Henry, yes.
Oh, my God. He was there for 100 years.
Yeah.
Yeah, he liked me.
So where are you living now?
I live in Lynn Shore Drive in Lynn.
Oh, very nice.
Yeah, I used to live in Swampscott, but the house was too big, so I had to downsize.
Great to see you, Mr. Rizzo.
Thank you for interviewing me.
All right. There you go, Jamie, an all-scholastic. This is Richard Vecchione, class of 59. What's it like to be here?
Wonderful.
Yeah. What street did you grow up on, Richard?
School Street, and I came from School Street just down. Oh. I still live in Chelsea.
Wow. Still living in Chelsea?
Yeah. I've had a stroke, but I'm doing fine.
Chelsea's come a long way since 1959.
Definitely. Yeah. A lot of new buildings. A
lot of new hotels.
Yeah.
Yep.
And there's another one being built.
That's right. Great to see you.
Nice to see you.
Okay. Hi, how are you?
Hi.
Oh, wow. Cynthia DePano?
Yeah.
Nice to see you.
Nice to see you.
Okay, and Gerald Laurie.
Yes. Good to see you.
We had the pharmacy. Remember the pharmacy?
Yes, of course.
Yeah.
So what's it like to be here today?
Oh, this is unbelievable. What a turnout we have.
Yeah.
These people are so...
That means we're still alive. The feet are working. You kiss. It's great to be here.
So what street did you two grow up on?
I grew up on Charmette, across from the cemetery.
Yes.
And it was a nice street then.
Yeah.
I shouldn't say that right now, but it was nice.
Yeah.
Loved Chelsea.
For all of us here today with high blood pressure, high cholesterol, diabetes, titanium hips, and whatever else ails you, we made it. And so I bid you well. Our class is the only class that always gets such a great turnout. Before I introduce our presidente, just a few words. Bobby, I promise never to call and bother you ever again. He always panics when he sees my name on his phone because he knows, here we go again. So I told Loretta to call him instead, and we blindsided him. But we could never have reunions if it wasn't for, wait for it, Mr. Robert Tiro, president of the class of 1959.
Hi, everybody. Excuse me. Well, let me tell you, Mitt is very gracious, but for all our reunions, being quite honest, she has been the spark plug that gets us going. So when I got a call from Minna, she said, Bob, 59 is 60. I said, really? Okay, 59 is 60. She's got a great place. I think you're going to love it. And as Minna said, I was kind of reluctant. Then I got a call from Loretta, who's Loretta Taylor Gordon. And sure, they were right. They've always been right. And I want to congratulate both those ladies, Minna, you especially, and Loretta Taylor Gordon for your role. You know, it's a long time. I wonder if we all can remember the old football field is where the Chelsea High is now. It's kind of unbelievable that we would come back and be here 59 years later in the city where it all began, Chelsea. I mean, truly, it's an amazing feat. And I'd like to congratulate us, because whether you realize it or not, the distances people came to come to this reunion, I'm just going to go through a few of the different places, states, where people came to this reunion, and it's interesting, if you will. Vermont, New York, New Jersey, New Hampshire, Nevada, Massachusetts, Kansas, Hawaii, Florida, and California. So we've kind of been blessed that we as a class, we don't forget. And I think it's obvious when you came here tonight or today, the camaraderie that's here, it is unbelievable. It truly is amazing. And I'll go one step further, okay? If in 5 years we have another one, I know Min is already thinking, maybe an assisted living placement someplace. That might be good. So I know Minna made mention, I hope everybody's taking their medication and we're ready to go. But before we do, I think we want to wish the people on the month of May their birthday, and there's a few of them. So if you will, the names I'm going to read, the people either have had their birthday or will have their birthday in this month of May. So will the people please rise as I call your name? Nunzio Scalabesco. Ronnie Simons. Nicholas Gianterco. Stephen Valtero. Carol Deander Kenny. Ellen McGinnis Holland. Pat Smith or Patricia Smith Anelli. John Clark. Virginia Abney Blake. Marie Donnarumma Manginello. John Faye. interestingly, you know as well as I, Linda Mays mentioned it, the committee that did and put this together, it's just unreal. Unselfish, a group, that's all I can tell you. If you were at our meetings, you would have known how people just wanted to help. And so what I'm going to do is mention these people, if you don't mind. They deserve to be mentioned. Obviously, Minna Marina, Minna Karis Marina, who spearheaded all of it. Minna? Loretta Taylor Gordon. Loretta is kind of our statistician, working hard, always has the books, making sure we have updated the number that comes to our reunion. Helen McGinnis Holland. Cynthia Sokolowski DePaolo. Jerry Laurie. Jay Barron. Wyatt. Frank Kozlowski. Walt. You, Butch Bradley. Howard Starish. Jackie Clark. A little mention about Howard. Howard suffered a heart attack down in Florida, if you hadn't heard. And our wishes and prayers go out to him and his family. He's done so much work. Last year, when we put this committee together, he was up from Florida the very next day. He's the one that gave you the paper outlet that you got, the invitation. So we wish Howard extreme good wishes, and our prayers go out to him. Now again, when we end our system, the Chelsea Cable TV is what you see. They have committed to do the video for our class. If you wish a video, you can go see Jay Barry. See Jay Barry Dwyer. It'll cost you $5. And if you wish, then you can't pick it up at the Chelsea Community Video Center. They will mail it to you, but it would be an extra $5. So the cost is $10. So please, if you are interested, you know, please do that. Again, all I can say is thank you for coming. It's amazing. Other classes have had somewhat of a chance to do what we've done, but nowhere have they got a response like this. And I say it's amazing to all of you. So again, make sure you got your medication, have a great time, enjoy. Oh, by the way, Loretta made mention, Loretta Taylor, there's an umbrella around my seat that someone may have left out in the front lobby. So if you are not, if you're missing that umbrella, it's over there. Thank you. I'm remiss if I don't say something. Those centerpieces that you have on the table, how many times Frank Kowalski has given his time and effort to make sure that we have those centerpieces. Frank, where are you? Thank you, Frank Kowalski, again.
Okay, Minna Karis Marino, they just told me the most valuable player on this committee. I'm going to hand you the microphone. Will you do me a favor and say hello to everybody and introduce everyone and see if they'd like to say something?
Maybe Pizzuto.
No, you do it, Minna. I'll talk to them.
Say hello.
Look at the camera, though.
You gotta look at the camera.
Introduce yourself.
Hello. I'm Janet Bennett Fee. Hello. We're glad to be here. Hi, Howie.
Say hello to Howie. Carol. Howie. Say hello to Howie. Carol.
Oh, I'm Patty Smith Aniello, and I want to thank Minna and the committee for putting on this fabulous reunion. And Howie, wherever you are at home resting, we miss you and we love you, and thanks for everything.
I'm Joe Aniello. I came along with Patty.
All right, your name? Say hello to the camera.
Is this for Howie?
Yes.
Hi, Howie. We're thinking of you. We miss you very much, and we love you. Take care. God bless.
Hi, everyone. Glad to be here, and nice to see all of you beautiful people.
Introduce yourself.
I'm Ginny Blake, Ginny Hafferty Blake. God bless.
Hi, Howie. I really miss you. I was really looking forward to seeing you again. This is Carol Keeley Woods, and I hope you're feeling fabulous. We're all thinking of you. Take care.
You're on TV. We just met your wife.
Which one?
The one that's here with you today.
Oh, she left already.
All right.
Yes, sir.
What do you want to say about being here today with your classmates?
Being here?
Yes.
Do I have to?
Well, it would help. We're on television.
Okay. It's wonderful to be in such an intimate setting with all my old friends and to see everybody. And have a wonderful time with them.
Where are you living now?
I am from North Las Vegas.
Oh, wow. How do you like living out there?
Wonderful.
Do you get to the casinos much?
Absolutely.
What's your favorite one?
They're all the same.
Yeah.
They're all the same, so.
You know they're building a casino next door in Everett.
Yes, sir. The old Wynn. Now it's the Encore.
It's the Encore, right.
Yes.
It's opening next June of 2019.
I know. It's gonna be nice.
Oh, yeah, it'll be beautiful.
I hope it's as nice as the one in Las Vegas.
Yes, it should be. It's about a $2.6 billion project.
Well, he has the money, so it should be good.
Great to see you.
Okay, same here.
All right. How are you? We know you. Say hello to the people of Chelsea.
Hi, how you doing?
You having fun?
I am definitely.
Introduce yourself. We know who.
My name is Joseph McCran, and I am having the best time of my life here because we're always close, this class.
Okay. Nice to see you.
Thank you.
Okay. Did you say a few words yet?
What kind of words?
Well, we're in Chelsea. What's it like to be back in your city where you grew up in?
It's great. It's always great to come back from Chelsea. We're here from Hawaii, actually.
Oh, wow.
Came in from Hawaii. Just for this. Wouldn't miss it.
How do you like living in Hawaii? What a great place.
Great to live in Hawaii. Everything's great about Hawaii. The weather, the people, everything.
Yeah, I was in Maui once. It was wonderful. And the Big Island is beautiful.
Yeah, Big Island's not so beautiful today, right now. The volcanoes are active right now, yeah?
Yep. Okay, so you had a long trip, but you're here, and it's nice to see you.
There you go. Nice to see everybody. Good. Yeah. All right.
Thanks.
Okay.
Oh, wow. You didn't even tell me you're a lieutenant colonel in the service.
Yep.
Thank you for your service to our country.
Thank
you. How'd you like it?
Great. It was great. 28 years was great. I retired from the Air Force 20 years ago. But it was good.
Where were you stationed mostly, sir?
Oh, everywhere. New Hampshire was the closest to here.
Yeah.
But I was in Taiwan where I met my wife. And Hawaii, of course. Texas, Mississippi. A few other places that I can't think of right now. All over.
It's very nice of you to do what you did for our country. Thank you.
Thank you. Thanks.
Okay. We're on TV. Yeah, and this is Paul Milner. Yeah, we're on Chelsea Television.
Me about Paul. I knew Paul when he was in the second grade.
Wow, so you've known him. Let's see him.
Yes. He looks good. He was a bit of a sloppy kid when I knew him.
Oh.
Do you remember that?
Oh, I guess.
Oh, that's so funny. Well, I grew up in Chelsea.
Yeah.
I went to Chelsea High only 1 year, but I went to Carter Junior High for 9 years.
Yeah.
Years. Everybody makes fun of me. I live in California now, Santa Barbara.
Oh, very nice.
I moved to L.A. for a year and came to hate it.
Yeah.
But now I live in a beautiful town.
Yeah. How do you like UCSB?
Oh, it's really come up.
It is. It's University of California, Santa Barbara.
That's right. You know?
Well, I'm familiar with their athletics, but anyway, you had a long trip to get here.
Yeah. Well, it wasn't bad. Five and a half hours.
Wow.
It's wonderful to know there's a whole a whole city that talks the way I do. Yes. I am made fun of all the time.
Do you get up to Disneyland much?
Oh, early on when I used to, yeah. My sister married a Los Angelino, an older sister.
Yeah.
When I was still a senior in high school, she married him from L.A. So I used to go to L.A. back in 1958, and it was beautiful and clean and safe. And so there was a point in time when my mom passed away, my husband sold a business, and we said, why don't we go to California?
Yeah.
So lived in L.A., and that's when I learned it's not for me. So Santa Barbara's beautiful. I love
Very
it.
Very nice. Nice to see you.
Nice seeing you.
Okay, Paul?
Yes, sir.
What part of Chelsea did you grow up in?
I grew up in the Cary Square area.
Yeah.
Went to the Carter School, which is no more there.
Right.
And then went to Chelsea High School.
And what did you do after high school?
I went to MIT for 4 years and then graduated and went to work for CBS Television and Network in New York. Unfortunately, I was drafted and spent 2 years in the Army, but when I got out, I went back to work for CBS, eventually working at their research labs in Stamford, Connecticut, where I stayed until 1975, and then I moved back to Massachusetts to work for a small hi-fi equipment company based in Norwood. So for the last 42 years, I've lived in Sharon.
Okay. How are you? Can you say a few words? We just talked to your wife. Oh, you're part of the Fay family?
Yes, yes. Jack Fay.
Yes. So where'd you grow up in Chelsea? What part?
Clinton Street.
Yeah.
Yep. I remember you. You worked for the Chelsea Record.
I do, and I still do.
You still
Can
do
you believe
them?
That?
Yeah.
Yes. So you're related to Tommy Fay and Jimmy Fay?
Yes, he's my cousin. I went through school with Tommy.
Oh, yeah. Quite a family, the Fays.
Yeah, yeah.
How do you like being back here today?
I like it. I haven't been back too frequently, but I like it. It's different.
Where are you living now?
I live in Kittery, Maine, and Hernando, Florida.
Very nice.
Yeah.
Very nice.
Thank
you. Enjoy your dinner. I didn't want to hold you up. Okay. It looks delicious.
Yeah, it does. Thank you.
Okay. How are you? Say hello to the camera. What's your name?
Norm.
Oh, Norman Finkelstein. I know you. You taught Hebrew school.
Yeah, I did indeed, among many other things.
Yes.
That's right.
And you taught regular school, everything.
I did. My lovely wife,
Roslyn. How are you, Roslyn? Nice to see you. Gee.
She also taught at Chelsea High School.
Oh, you taught at Chelsea?
Yes.
What years were you there at Chelsea High?
65 to 69.
Okay, and how about you, Mr. Finkelstein? What years were you there?
65 to 70.
Okay. How do you like being back in Chelsea?
We come back from time to time to visit, you know, the old stomping grounds.
Yep.
And while it's changed, it's the same.
So when did you two get married?
We got married in 67, of course.
1967. You liked them right away, huh? Love at first sight?
No, we met in third grade, really.
Oh, okay. All right.
At the Shirtliff School.
At the Shirtliff School. And here we are back about 60 years later.
We were much younger then.
Yeah. Was your wedding like the prince and the princess today?
Well, it was, only she wouldn't let me wear the crown.
Did you watch the wedding, the royal wedding? Wasn't it a marvelous?
Just beautiful.
Yes. I wish that couple well. They're very nice.
I don't know if there was a local Chelsea caterer there, however.
Well, I don't know. So Chelsea's special, isn't it? Special place.
It is. I mean, we are proud of our origins.
Yeah.
We're glad to be from Chelsea. I still think it's a unique thing. I mean, look around here. Here are some people, some of them almost my age, okay? And look at the number of people who come back, you know, from far and wide because of those Chelsea roots.
So what subject did you teach at Chelsea High?
I taught German.
So you're obviously fluent in German.
At this point, not very. But I can still order food in a German restaurant. And when I'm in Berlin, I can find my way around.
What subject did you teach, Mrs. Finkelstein?
Spanish.
Oh, ¿Cómo está?
Muy bien.
Tengo un buen día. Con mucho gusto. Okay, I took you out of line, so enjoy your dinner.
Okay, thank you.
Okay,
thank
enjoy
you.
Your dinner.
Great to see you.
Nice to see you. Always a pleasure. How you doing? What a time we're having here.
I think you see what I meant when I say the camaraderie of this group, of the 59 yes. class. It's really something. It's great. When I was teaching, one of the things I would love to have had our kids in school feel this camaraderie that we have
yes.
and filter it down. It's something.
Okay, and Minna's being so humble about her contribution to this. She did a lot.
Minna, let's put it so you'll understand. It's Minna who determined, not determined, but went out and found this place.
Yeah.
And she went out and realized quite instinctively, it's great to have the 59 year now, then wait till 60. So she's been really a spark plug in all of it.
We have a beautiful day and everyone's having a great time.
I think they are. You see for yourself.
Yes. Yeah. Okay, enjoy your dinner.
Thank you, Gare.
Bobby, Barry Dwyer to you forever. Since first grade at Sheridan School. That J came years later. Barry Dwyer.
Jerry Laurie, Williams School.
Butch Bradley, Williams School, and real happy to be a part of this class. Let me tell you that right now and forever.
Okay, Frank Kowalski, Carter School and Chelsea High School, class of 59.
This was quite a committee.
What?
It was a great committee?
Yes, the best. Williams School.
She said Williams School's the best.
Well, that's debatable. I mean, really, you know, Loretta and I. Would...
Williams is only second to Shurtleff.
Shurtleff, the green and gold, right?
What,
the blue and white.
Well, we, you know, we were the star, I think. Right, Loretta?
Right.
We were.
But you came together from all over the city and became Chelsea High classmates. That's the important thing.
And that, I told you so much more before. It shows you how we all just feel the same way about each other. It's a coming together.
Since it's a special class, why is that so, Minna?
Why is that so?
We had nowhere else to go but
we had nowhere else to go but with each other.
No one else would have us.
I didn't want to go there. Min is on me all the time about this. Why is it so? Because there's more Shurtleff School kids that made it. But on this committee, it's Williams School all the way. All the way.
Oh, Carter. Yeah, Carter too.
Yeah.
Carter School, with Frank Kowalski,
yes.
and me.
Yeah. You like Carter School, huh?
Carter School actually started in Prattville School from 1 to 6, and then Carter School from 7 to 6, 7, 9, and then up to the dear old Chelsea High School, the old Chelsea High School, not the new one today, the old hallowed halls of Chelsea High School, right. which this class hung together all these years, and now almost 60 years later, we're still hanging together. And we have the best classmates that you could possibly imagine.
Now, the Carter School is where Carter Heights is right now, the apartment building.
Yeah, that's the old Carter School, unfortunately, had a fire and was demolished, and now it's become Carter Heights. So. Yeah. Again, it's one of those things, history of Chelsea.
Yes. Yep. Okay.
Williams School crowd, we've been together since kindergarten.
Really?
That's,
wow.
Yeah, kindergarten through high school.
Now, who was the principal of Williams School? Was it Mr. Siegel?
Mr. Williams and then Mr. Carter.
Okay, was Mr. Siegel there at that time, Maury Siegel?
Later on in the years, we were already in high school.
Oh, okay.
Yes.
All right.
Yes.
Okay, anybody else on the committee want to say anything? No?
Mr. Carter's daughter was supposed to be here. I think she was ill, Maggie Carter.
Oh, wow.
And he was our principal.
He was the principal at the Williams
School? At one time, yes, yeah. Mr. Wright.
Who was the high school principal?
Oh, I don't
Who was the high school principal when you were in high school?
Canelli.
Yeah, well, two. Canelli.
Canelli.
Margolis.
Yeah, Canelli.
Well, it was Canelli.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay, any other trivia? No? Oh, you beat Everett. Hold on. That's special.
59.
Really?
Yes, we did.
Well, 59, you were already out because they play in the fall. So, 57, 58?
57, 58.
That's remarkable. You beat him twice. Who was the star? Who was the quarterback?
Well, it depends on what year you're talking about. That, well, I was, we were juniors. So, Jimmy Walker was, yeah.
Jimmy Walker wasn't there.
Oh, God, I'm trying to think. You know, when it isn't your year, but I can remember the people of our year that was on that team. Freddie Nowicki, Tony Rizzo, Eddie Evans. Who else? It was there. Griffin, I think, and I'm trying to think of others, but that's what you remember. You remember your group of kids. And in our year that we won, which was Eddie Evans at quarterback, and you can go right down the list of the same group of people.
Were you at the game, Minna? Do you remember it?
Cheerleader.
She was there cheerleading.
How many cheerleaders are here tonight?
Myself, Cynthia. Beverly, Selma, Patty Smith.
Nobody beat Everett two times, I don't think, except this class.
Two out of three years. Wow. 2 out of 3 years.
That's remarkable. Everett, nobody beats Everett twice, especially nowadays.
It was after the Everett Stadium burned down. Remember there was a fire? And we said, aha, now they can't spy on us. And that's when we won.
Okay. You having a good time?
Very good. Yeah.
That's great.
Yep.
Where do you see our dessert table?
Oh, wait. We have a dessert table. What do we have?
Tiramisu. Yeah. A cake. Yes. And kugel.
Are you serious?
Yeah. Kugel.
Oh,
yeah.
My word.
We run a kosher kitchen.
You donated the kugel.
It's out of my Jewish heritage that I remember.
Tell me about your kugel.
This is not kugel. This is Lakshin kugel. Lakshin kugel. And it's very well made. It's the best around. We had it at the Lori's house for Pesach last year.
Yeah.
And it took everything by storm. So that's a little from my heritage from Bonnie and Bessie Gittles' grocery store on Everett Avenue. And I carry that with me through my heart and through the years.
The great things about Chelsea, all the faiths that have come together for years and years, right? As one. Anything else, Minner?
Interesting. And it's true. No matter where you go, everybody says the same. You'll meet someone from Chelsea. Whether you're at one end of the country or the other, you seem to find somebody who comes from Chelsea.
What was Missouri? We met somebody from Chelsea.
Yeah.
Yeah, at one of the bars, of course. Yeah.
Okay. Minnie, you want to wrap this up for the people in Chelsea watching?
No.
Oh, as you can tell, that was unscripted. That's the one of the things. It's TV. You never know what's going to happen. All right. I think the DJ wants to put some music on. Is that okay? Give him the go-ahead. George Athens is looking to put on some music. All right. Thank you, Mr. President.
Oh, you're very welcome. Thank you very much for doing what you're doing.
Hey, wait a minute.
Wait a minute. Oh, wait.
Just on behalf of the committee, I want to make sure that Howie Darish wish him a very quick recovery.
Okay, Mr. Darish, they just wish you a speedy recovery, and everyone's having a great time and thinking about you. Okay.
And we'll see you all in 5 more years.
Yes.
Get well, Howard.
Get well,
Howard.
Okay, thank you very much.
Okay, good.
How are you, everybody?
Thank you.
It seems every wonderful thing must come to an end. And my friend Jamie, who's been the cameraman tonight, I've done so much work with him through the years, through sports and sports shows with Dookie. And I was vice president of the class of 1959, which was just a great, great time, great years, with wonderful memories. And this has been a tremendous night. And Jamie asked me to say all of the cable listeners that Linda, come over here, sweetheart. Come on, Lynn. Come on. This makes it special. This is Linda Newman Siegel, but all my girls I call by their maiden name. But Linda and I went not only through the high school 3 years, we went all the way through shirtless school together. That makes it very special. We know each other's families. We've been through a lot together. And this is one of the reasons why I'm here, and one of the reasons that I wish I had to say that Sandra Rosnoff is not here, and Linda and I are not too happy about that. But we had a great time, and to all you listeners, thank you very much.
All right, we're leaving now. Is that it? All right, well, as usual, the class of 59 excelled in one of the greatest venues and times that we could possibly have. All we do is try to make memories for ourselves, because there's no better gift in our life than a memory. We'll take that with us. We'll all remember it. We'll reflect on it, and we'll get a smile on our face, and it'll make us feel good. So, sei gesund, be gesund, and that's that.
No.
No.
I thought you wanted to sing the Williams School song. I would yell at you.
The rest.
Our boys are fighting
to win the game.
No fighting.
We want the team.
We got the team.
Chelsea High.
Oh, all right.
Bye bye. Thank you.
Thank you.
When does the ship go?
I know I. Okay. Minna, this was a colossal success. You're amazing. Come here. I know it was your idea to bring them all together for this happy occasion, and it turned out beautifully.
But it was because of Frank Kowalski. The reason we had this reunion is because of Frank Kowalski, on a chance when he said to me, why do we have to wait for the 60th? And I said, he's right. And Loretta agreed, Cynthia agreed, Helen agreed, and Tiro agreed. So here we are.
This is a wonderful tribute to the class of 59, that we have such a wonderful turnout of all our classmates here. And it was such a pleasure to do everything to contribute to this great night.